Hi business owners, this is your business coach Nalin Mehta and welcome to my talk series which is named Kya Karun, especially recorded for you. You know, I often hear businessmen say that my whole day goes in running after one crisis or the other. I work very hard, but I'm just running after one trouble after the other and I just don't get to sit back and think and plan. Well, this crisis syndrome is one of the biggest barriers to the growth of any business. You are running after solving problems, you are working very hard, you work 12 hours a day, and then when you go home in the evening and you think, you can't conclude what you did today. You know, you get this feeling that I did not do anything today. Now friends, look at the slide which your screen is showing now. So there are jobs which are very, very important for your business, for its survival, for its growth. And then there are jobs which are very, very urgent. So what really happens is that our whole day is going in the very urgent and very important jobs. Of course, they have to be handled. You as business owner are accountable for your business. You are accountable to keep the production running. You are accountable for the customer's commitments to be met. You are accountable to the bankers. You are accountable to the regulatory authorities. So you do have to handle one after the other things which are definitely very, very important. Now, why do they really become urgent? Because if you don't get time to handle important things over a period of time, they become urgent. Now, when they become urgent and important, you really get fatigued, and to rest, you end up doing things which are in the lower quadrants of the slide that I showed. So you end up doing emails or Google something. It's basically you're trying to rest and relax. So here is my suggestion for you. See, you have to handle urgent and important things to keep the business running, and please continue doing that. I'm not saying that you stop that. I just want to give you one mantra, just one change of your style of functioning. So if out of the 250 hours that you work in a month, just keep 2 hours into, let's say, 3 or 4 times, about 8 hours, for something that I'm going to tell you now. Just sit down and write down which are the crises and important things that happen very, very frequently, which department they come from, and they really take your attention away from what you want to do. The thing is that while you are handling those crises, you are working in the business and not on the business. Now, all you have to do is just institute an hour or two meeting for those items which happen very frequently with the relevant department. Just pick one item and call a larger set of people from that department to discuss, and use the method of brainstorming. You will be amazed at the suggestions that will come on how to solve those issues. Simply write down the processes and the procedure to solve those problems and implement those suggestions which come, and I can assure you, in just a few months, you will see a sea change in the way you work. Let me give you an example. You know, I am recently been consulting a client who said that, you know, he's all the time having the stress of his production line, you know, stopping and the quality getting suffered and a lot of rework happening. It's a real challenge. The gentleman works from morning to night and he's not able to give enough focus on marketing, market development. He wants to grow and put up a second plant. He simply doesn't have the time to do all that. Now, I gave him the same suggestion. So he kind of did a brainstorming. I call this a functional review. he called a larger set of people, not only the production manager, but also the couple of production supervisors and couple of quality supervisors. And he started brainstorming as to what is really happening on the production line and why we always have some crisis or the other. Sometimes material is not there, sometimes line is stopping for some other reason, sometimes quality defect has come. How are we actually managing this whole thing? And you will be amazed what came out of that discussion. The whole thing that came out was nothing to do with production. Basically, that organization had a process where salespeople would call the production supervisor and start telling him what they need urgently. So a production supervisor will get two or three such calls every day, and he will keep altering the production schedule based on those calls. A simple process of instructing the salespeople that they will only talk to the production planning guy and not talk to the production supervisor, and also instituting a simple process which came out of that brainstorming, that production schedule will remain firm and rigid for 2 days and it will be rolling every 2 days, started improving the situation. Now there was another brainstorming and a similar functional review done with the sales team, and sales team came out with their challenges. They said, we need to tell the customer when we are getting the product, so unless we ring up the production supervisor, we don't come to know. So there was a simple process instituted that in the evening, every evening, the production planning person will send a simple Excel sheet to every salesman giving the expected date of delivery for the orders of that salesman. So therefore, they don't have to call the production line every now and then. And then for such extreme emergencies where the production schedule does need a change, the authority to change the production schedule was rested with the business owner. Now, this simple process reviews, you know, which I call, reviewing for strategy, process and enhancement, solve the issues, and the businessman today does not have so many production crises. In fact, he himself, in his own words, they have reduced to half, and he's able to therefore devote his time to other functions of the organization. He is now really working on the business. So, dear business owners, please continue to handle important and urgent jobs. But if you follow this process of doing functional review in a manner of brainstorming and writing down some of the processes, you know, which will help you eliminate that urgency, and an important thing will be handled when it is important and will not be handled much later when it becomes important and urgent, I think will go a long way to help you run your business better. So I hope this particular talk in the series of my Kya Karu talk helps you to manage your business better and manage important things of the business and help you to work on the business so that you can make it grow and prosper. Thank you so much.